Indeed, it's a really very pleasant noon, minus the humidity part. My name is Mausmi Prasad, and I work here as an assistant professor at the Department of Management Sciences. And I'll be the host for today's ceremony. I, on behalf of Bloom's department, extend a warm welcome to the guest, Dr. Kajoli Banerjee Krishnan, our alumnus and practicing industrial physicist for more than 3 decades. I also welcome her husband, Professor Rishikesh Krishnan, Director, IIM Bangalore, and also the guest of honor for today. I also welcome Professor Sudhir Jaiswal, Chairperson PGPEX BLM program from IIM Calcutta, Professor Kripa Shankar and Professor Jayanta Chatterjee, our former faculty, family and friends of the graduating students. Our graduating students and our own faculty, staff, media, and current students. It is an absolute delight to see you all here in person. To all the graduating students, I offer my warmest congratulations on your academic success. I'm certain that you, your family and friends, and all of us here are proud of your achievements as you are graduating from one of the top institutes of the country. As you graduate and start out in your career, I so hope that you remain in touch with the domes and also with one another. Let me also state that this year is indeed special for us for many reasons, but I'll state 3 reasons here. First, we are celebrating our Golden Jubilee, marking our 50 years of being into this institute. Second, we do that with our new name change. So this is Department of Management Sciences from the earlier Industrial and Management Engineering. Finally, we are proud to host the current batch, which is one of the biggest in our own history. So this is indeed our time of celebration. Before proceeding with the ceremony, let me make some housekeeping points. The seats have been marked with the roll numbers of the graduating students, so please make sure you occupy your marked seats. For friends and family, we have tried our best to accommodate many of you inside the hall, but should you find yourself in search of a seat, please be sure that we have enough seats outside the hall with the provision for live telecast. Right. The toilets are on your left side of this hall, and should you need any assistance with the baby need or any other need, please feel free to reach out to our volunteers who are here to help us. Coming to the agenda for today, we will begin the ceremony with the Vandana, then we will follow on with the report of the department presented by the head. I will introduce then the guest of honor and begin with the award ceremony. Later, Professor Rishikesh Krishnan will make his speech here, and we will also hear from some of our own graduating students. This will be followed by the vote of thanks and a high tea served right outside this hall. I will now invite Chanda for the Saraswati Vandana.
Good afternoon, everyone. I extend my heartiest congratulations to all the graduating students and a warm welcome to all the parents once again, the faculty members. So let's start the ceremony by offering prayer to Ma Saraswati and seeking her blessings.
स्वर्ग की देवी संगीत तुझसे
हर शब्द तेरा है हर गीत तुझसे, तू स्वर की देवी है संगीत तुझसे, हर शब्द तेरा है हर गीत तुझसे, हम हैं अकेले हम हैं अधूरे, अपनी शरण ले हमें प्यार दे माँ, हे शारदी माँ हे शारदी माँ, अज्ञानता से हमें तार दे माँ, मुनियों ने समझी है गुणियों ने जानी, वेदों की भाषा पुराणों की वाणी, मुनियों ने समझी है गुणियों ने जानी, वेदों की भाषा पुराणों की वाणी, हम भी तो समझे हम भी तो जाने, विद्या का हमको ये अधिकार दे माँ, हे शारदी माँ हे शारदी माँ, हे शारदी माँ हे शारदी माँ। थैंक यू।
After a significant conversation with or discussion or maybe conflict or maybe we can even call a war between the various stakeholders of the department. Finally, after a 10-year debate and discussion, we have found that we should move towards the Department of Management Services. It has two reasons. One is that the branding, obviously, which, but the second component which we were more keen, which has an underlying logic, is that management at one time was supposed to be seen as an art rather than science. And now with the explosion of data and the kind of tools and techniques available, any decision in management is essentially backed by data, irrespective of which functional area we are talking about, from HR, PS, any of these. So we thought we should leverage the technology strength of IIT Kanpur and call ourselves not studies but science. So we moved from an industrial engineering kind of model to a science model wherein we have brought all of this. Of course, we also experimented with Department of Innovation Management and Engineering, keeping the same name but with the same acronym. But somehow we finally landed in Department of Management Sciences. Of course, some of our faculty are still unhappy with this, but still we are trying to see how that can be addressed. It seems some awards are only given to engineering discipline. So essentially, now we lost the tag. So essentially, we may not be getting those awards. We will not be qualified. Something like that. But we are working out a solution for that. So, it shouldn't be an issue. And in 2024, we started our celebration of 50 years. The master's program basically we started from the department, and in March and April I think we had a series of events, and we are planning to have a few more in the next upcoming semester from August onwards. The planning is still on, not in place, we are working on it. Okay, this month is vacation, so we would work maybe from next month onwards. So, the second component is that we had increased our batch strength from earlier. We used to have we were stable at 14. Normally what I have seen in my 10-15 years is that 13, 14, sometimes we went up to 16, then we went back to 12, we went again, came back to 13 kind of a thing. We increased the faculty strength to 30 now. 29, one will be joining shortly, so it will be 30. And that has improved. I mean, we have also we are also exploring into other disciplines like development, economics, policy, you know, social economics, energy, environment. So many of these areas which are not earlier considered part of the department are now part of the department's portfolio. So, and of course, our faculty, as usual, are highly productive. That comes because we are in Kanpur and because there is nothing else to do in Kanpur. And you can't visit the same mall however many times you want to go. So essentially we end up doing most of the work, and because of which our output is significant. So these are the new entrants. Yeah, now when I look at them, I suddenly feel very, very, very bored. Seriously. And until now I was not feeling very well, but now, you know, Saurav, look at it. I know that now I am old. So basically I have a grip. And then, yeah. So all these five who have joined recently are highly qualified and are into the data sciences and other areas, which are relatively. Department is essentially still going with their math background in terms of faculty, so faculty essentially has to have a very strong fundamental this thing in math. We may change at some point, but fundamental math is approved. 10 plus 12 is supposed to be needed. So we can also see that the ratio between male and female is significant. Earlier we never used to have any female faculty, very few, but our is one of those departments which has a significant ratio of female faculty, and they rule the roost. So if anything has to be get done, you have to approach one of the female faculty rather than the male. And of course, some of these achievements which are already on our side, and which won around who got the excellence in teaching award. And of course, he's also blessed with a baby boy, right, recently. So both of them, he got double whammy in terms of award and so now, he's not here, unfortunately. We would have loved to have him. And now in the MBA component, we have the standard portfolio with the kind of that which comes in, the education background. Primarily, we take engineering students or science students. I think we are now going beyond that. Yes, that's one change which we have done. We said that we would like to take any undergraduate degree, but the person should have MAT at the 10 plus 2 level. So it doesn't matter whether you are an economist, sociologist, whatever it is, but up to 10 plus 2, you need to have a basic MAT. Otherwise, understanding our faculty would be very tough. So we thought that we should allot it. So this is what we have done, and I think we most probably will have more diversity in our student population. And yeah. And of course, we are in an NIR of 24 rank. We actually dropped down from this thing, but we'll reach out. So I think in a year or so, we'll be back in the saddle in terms of ranking. So that's not a problem. Yeah. And of course, what is more important for us is that whether we teach or not, we need to see whether we could get to good place. You know, so whatever we do, unless you get fully placed, then whatever ranking or whatever it is, our admissions are definitely going to be affected. So both parents and students alike, though we try our best to leave you with some teaching which will be useful in your job profiles, but it is an uphill task for us. So placement, you can check, these are the kind of placement. We are always 100% placed in almost every year, and year on year growth is significantly high for us. Maybe not as equivalent to as those 1 crore, 2 crore, 5 crore salary, which I really don't believe most of the time, but still, yeah, they are in the press, so I don't know. And we do have this BAC 24 listing. So these BAC have been very attractive in there. These are the people who actually pushed us to start the Golden Jubilee celebration in the month of March and April. They actually arm twisted us and said that we have to do, even though we are leaving, we want to do this before we go for term. And that is why, you know, this batch took a very strong initiative and did that. And of course, they also had a problem because they could not do much about their junior batch. Normally, there is a kind of a, you know, relationship which starts up with the junior and the senior batches. I'm not going into the negative part of it, but the positive part of it. There is some kind of a learning curve there, but in this case, what happened is this batch was on the back foot because the next batch was 170 students. This batch is just 30. There was no way they could even compete with the first year. But anyway, they still managed. Yeah. To give them a good initiation into the system. And MTech, of course, is a flagship program, as many of you might know. This is basically what we are really proud of in our 50 years and has a huge legacy. I will come to the legacy at some point, but yeah, this is one of our very, very critical program. We wanted to go with more than a couple of more, but I think there was a change in the path we wish to take in this regard. And of course, MTech placements are also basically, I believe, are 100%. This year we had some problems, I think those are solved now, but I need to check. Yeah, and this is the MTech batch, and then we have the capstone engagement, which is unique for IIT, which we started, I think, about 10 years back, where we said that MBA students should have some leeway in exploring and having some experience in working while they are doing their MBA, because we take undergraduates who are fresh out of college, unlike the US colleges where they have a requirement of 3 or 4 years of minimum experience. And given that, we thought that this would be a good idea where they can actually explore an industry problem as a consulting assignment or equivalent to a one semester kind of a work, starting in the first year somewhere and going. So this also came out very well, but yeah, it has its own, it's a learning curve for us, and these are the kind of companies, the kind of domain-wise internship which we were able to. A lot of companies have been on board and they are really looking forward to going with this program because they have a continual manpower for one whole year can work. This is an initiative, though this initiative is an IIT Kanpur initiative basically at the central level. Our department was the first to take advantage of this and start up with two, and now we are four. We most probably will be going to six programs in this, and this we want to now expand. Maybe six we may stop at this point, the faculty which we have, but here all the programs are very sought after, highly subscribed. How do you know that they are sought after? It's because I get recommendation calls from people at IFSL asking whether we could get them somebody a seat into this program. That's how I know that this program became very popular and very sought after. So we don't do that.
Yeah.
The IIT. Such things don't happen. And these are our, some of our students, Dean Master, we do a campus initiation program every year or every batch or every cohort. Where I think it is a campus initiation program, CIP, right?
Yes.
Where they come and enjoy 3 days here, play all the games with all the facilities, and in between listen to boring talks from boring people like me. But still, we have to make it. So this is something we should do. This is one of the flagship programs which we are very proud of, because visionary leadership manufacturing is something which came out even before the current government said we have to push it to manufacturing, we have to support manufacturing. This program came way back, 15 years back. This thought came that the engineers who have gone from their undergraduate degrees and are working for 4 or 5 years should be brought back, reskilled, retrained, retaught, so that they can go and start their own ventures, or they can go to the senior management level in the manufacturing domain, bringing in into the Indian manufacturing new practices, and that is why the collaboration was with Japan, and then these students also go to Japan, and it's a 1 year program. The one thing which we also want to explore at some point is whether we could make it a full-time 1 year residential program in each institute with the faculty going around, which we are still, it's on the drawing board, and increase the number of seats which are available in this program. So, but there is space constraint, so we are working on it. Hopefully we should be able to do it. This is one of the highest, in terms of fees, it is one of the highest for an IIT.
Our fees is supposed to be low. That is why our return on investment is very high. This is not in the same league. The same league comes out 18 or 16 lakh, something like that for a year. I can't afford it, so. So this is the batch, this is there, and then the profile of the batch. Yeah, most of them actually end up going for jobs. Very few of them start their own ventures, which we want to push more and more in the future. And this is the batch.
And now coming to the student activity, which this batch had actually done. Pushed us, threatened us, blackmailed us, did dharnas for them to organize this in North Central. We said, you can't do this, you have midsums, you have endsums, you will fail, and then you come crying to us. No, they said, we will not do it, we will do, and then finally they killed us for it. Somehow we survived, and they organized both Prabandhan, which is the annual management festival of IME department, Tom's department, sorry, still get the IME department. And all these events have been done in 3 years at very short notice, that gives them as some confidence that these people are at least adept at managing crisis at some point. So the students, we have trained them well, so they actually did some crisis management and organized everything, I think, in 10 to 15 days max. Did he come? No, yeah. I think I am talking about, I don't know, yeah. I mean, Shoko is here somewhere. He is the one who actually, I thought he was from Kanpur. So this is Prabandhan. And then we also do a year-long industry event where speakers are invited to talk. Earlier we used to do it on the online. During COVID we went online, but this is more of giving them an industry flavor in terms of what they are learning, and this is a very active series which we do, and many of the industry stalwarts are here too. And of course the interior design is here to see whether they could do a placement also. That's a secondary thing, but yeah, primarily it is meant for non-MK.
Oh, and Vox Populi is another event which we have done this year.
I think this happened both of them, right? So, and of course, the Mosby, who is now before me, who has talked, was the one who survived them, basically, not me. So, which is good. And also, of course, the one of the newer faculties, you know, Vivekita is the one who actually bore the brunt of these kids.
So reflection, and then we do a lot of research seminars and webinars. So you can see this is Professor R. Sharma is also our distinguished professor of practice. He is also an alumnus, but
he is more famous for the unique identification, the Aadhaar program, which he single-handedly along with Nandan brought into now. Without Aadhaar we can't go anywhere. That's a problem for us, but yeah, getting an Aadhaar also has become difficult.
So, they did it, so he is now part of our department faculty. We hear about a week back. And of course, our students also have been encouraged to go for competitions, win competitions, or lose competitions, it doesn't matter, but we supported them throughout the year. And the Research Scholar Awards, yeah. All these, I think, yeah, Best Paper Award. He is a working jointly with Bartholomew University. And he moved. Zai is just one. His paper is
just now. Just came out,
isn't it? Yeah. Okay. And of course, we have Prime Minister Research Fellows.
You may be wondering why is it significant, because you should have 30,000 which we pay, the research scholar should pay 70k a month for the PhD student who gets selected. Other than that, of course, the prestige of being a Prime Minister Research Fellow in a competition which is over the throughout the country.
So these are our Prime Minister Research Fellows. And we have, as I told you, we had an international collaboration with the PhD joint degree program in Dartmouth, Curtin and many other universities, dual degree program with Milwaukee, University of Milwaukee. Here, this started just this year.
It came very late, but at least I think one of our students was selected, and most probably he gets the visa to travel, unless Trump comes in and then we don't get a visa.
And we have all of these are joint degree scholars with Curtin and with Dartmouth.
We do a good amount of work with Dartmouth, and it has come out significantly well, and the quality of both the work and the kind of application is significantly good, and we collaborate because they push us and we push them, so finally something came out. And
these are our distinguished professors who have been there. R. Sharma, you are the now, National Health, earlier he was Chair Troy, then he was also for the Aadhaar. Ajay Kumar was the former Defense Secretary.
These articles regularly come in the newsroom and are also posted on our website and social media.
He is a very prolific writer. And Lalitam Kapoor, if you are having weight problems, he is the man to go to. He has come with a series of programs which allows you to reduce weight significantly, and he comes here and teaches a course. Sometimes it's a half semester, sometimes it's a full semester kind of report on how to do this. And it seems he's very successful and sought after. Now we can't get time from him to come here. And Sanjay Tandon is the DRDO chain here, the DRDO Center's director. And then we have Kevin Venturini, she's a new faculty from Italy who has come to do some research for us, and they have given her an offer. And I think on social entrepreneurship.
Now, why we are saying our M-Techs are, they love our M-Techs is because all three of them are our M-Techs.
and he has just become the chief executive officer, and Vivasan is also our alumnus, and Ashwini Vaishnav is also our alumnus. These both essentially are also the students of Professor Raghavan, who was not able to come here, but yeah. He was the founding director of IIIT Bangalore for 20 years. So, have, of course, we have a lot of famous people, but I think you'll get bored. Let's not get into that. These are the recent ones whom you would like to show. And these are some of our distinguished alumni who are there. And Shantanu is one of the first, I think. We ran a program in management, the first program in MEM or something. It ran only for 1 year. So he's the first student of the first program. We still work with him quite closely. And Nimruti is also there, she's in Calcutta, I think. Yeah. And so on and so forth. For a first, in a long time, we actually did an alumnus meet in Noida. And our students have done a good job of connecting and getting them together. So initially, as management people, we thought that, okay, like what we do for NIT Kanpur, we should bring each batch and let them celebrate. But then the batch size are very low, and when we call a batch, it is very difficult for us to get the numbers, and people drop off in the last. So we said, okay, let us know all the batches, at least this set of batches together. So this is very successful. And this was also, in some sense, I think mostly survived it, in some sense or other, yeah. So she was the one who took lead in this. And this was very successful. I think 70 alumni attended, 80 alumni have attended in Noida, and they are still in touch. So that's a good news for us. And of course, Dr. Hrishikesh Krishnan is our alumnus again. And he is currently the director of IIM Bangalore. He was earlier director of IIM Indore. And he is a frequent so today when I have seen the main convocation also, all the three people are sitting there for all the alumni. So, but here we have to break tradition because I am not an alumnus. So essentially, so Professor Hrishikesh, he is the alumnus. I don't need to give the introduction, she will do the introduction on us. Yeah. But I know him very well, he has been very supportive to us over the years in bringing excellence to our department. No nonsense kind of a person. Calls a spade and doesn't brook much, does not do much of this thing, so nonsense. So you have to be on your toes when you're talking to me. Please be careful, okay?
Not true.
So is our department, total number of graduate students this year or
see? E-Masters, 88. So when you don't study on campus, you have more incentive to come and do the convocation. Baki logan ke liye, the other guys, it is like ghar ka murghi dal barabar.
Anyway, we have a good strength. And he got, I think he's here because he got the award in the morning.
Chairman is now busy with that. I think he is made chairman of the NEET thing, the committee which looking into the NEET.
And this is something which we normally have a review every 3 years or 5 years, and then the eminent people from industry and the academia come, stay with us for 3-4 days, talk to all stakeholders and come up with a set of recommendations on what we should do in the future. literature. So some of their recommendations are here, and most of them we have been able to, in some sense or other, follow, and we are looking for the next level of acceleration in terms of the visibility and in terms of taking DOMS on. And in the future directions, okay, so now let me give you a statutory warning or a caveat here. This is, I have discussed this in the faculty meeting the other day, and people said this is your vision, not our vision. So we are still working on that. Between me and faculty, we are working on it, okay? We'll work on it, and somehow we'll manage to come somewhere. But yeah, what our primary vision is to move into a school of management sciences, and to move into a school of management with significant verticals. We are the now the for moving into a school of management sciences. The base requirement is that we need 100 crores. So that's where all you guys come in. That's what I was trying to tell you. All you guys come in. So we'll be approaching you guys. But yes, we are on the way. There are a significant group of alumni who have shown keen interest. We have been talking to them. We are working with a larger academic council from our alumni, from industry, and from our internal faculty members to give shape to the thought process on why a school, how a school, and what it should do, and what is the kind of vision we are looking forward. And hopefully we should at some point in time, maybe if not in the coming next 2 years, in a decade or so, we should be able to do this, definitely. Hopefully I want to do it in the next 2-3 years. Let's see. Of course, it all depends on how much all of you guys are going to chip in. That we'll talk later.
So these are main this thing. These centers essentially are
just thoughts in my head which I brainstormed with other faculty members. So some of our my colleagues essentially don't agree with some of them. Nomenclature will change, but the concept of having centers of excellence in different domains is the foundation. The kind of excellence in center of center we need to have, that needs to grow up. Let's hope we can do something. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you, Professor Fani, for that presentation, and I'm sure we will continue to build that legacy. A lot of what goes inside is already there with you. But let me just congratulate the graduating students once again. So congratulations. And today we are honored to have with us Professor Hrishikesh Krishnan, Director and Professor of Strategy at the Indian Institute of Management, Bangalore. He was earlier Director of IIM Indore. He is currently the Ram Charan Chair Professor in Innovation and Leadership, and earlier held the Jamuna Raghavan Chair in Entrepreneurship at IIMB from 2007 to 2010. Professor Krishnan is an alumnus of IIT Kanpur, which we are really proud of. He is also an alumnus of Stanford University and IIM Ahmedabad. His main areas of interest are strategy and innovation. He has been listed in the Thinkers 50 India list of most influential management thinkers from India. Apart from his academic publications, which are many and hence I have skipped them, Professor Krishnan has written 2 books, 8 Steps to Innovation, Going from Jugaad to Excellence, co-authored with Vinay Dabholkar, which won the Best Book Award for the year 2013-14 from the Indian Society for Training and Development, and From Jugaad to Systemic Innovation, The Challenge for India. Professor Krishnan has extensive corporate board and advisory experience. He is currently on the boards of National Payments Corporation of India, Wheels India Limited, and the Higher Education Planning, Higher Education Financing Agency. He has served on several committees set up by the Government of India and prominent industry associations related to innovation in India. He is the member of CII National Committee on Technology, Innovation and Research, and the CII National Higher Education Committee. Professor Krishnan was a member of the Expert Committee set up by the Government of India in the year 2017-18 under the chairmanship of Justice B.N. Sri Krishnan to propose a data protection framework for India. Professor Krishnan co-founded one startup and was the CEO of another. He has been on the jury of Economic Times Startup Awards. He is currently on the advisory board of Your Nest Investment Advisors. We are humbled to have you here in person. Welcome. So what I have done is really, read his profile in very, very brief, keeping up with the time. Do find time and go through his profile and some of the amazing works that he has been doing and leading at IIM Bangalore. I will now invite our guest of honor to please come on the stage for the award of the degree. I also invite our DPGC, Professor Amit Shukla, to call upon the graduating students from the programs of PhD, M.Tech and MBA to receive their degrees.
Good evening, everyone. Sir, I present the candidates of the Department of Management Sciences, who, having satisfied the requirements for the degree of PhD, is considered worthy of receiving the same. I recommend that she be admitted to the said degree. Seema Portluri. In absentia, Sonal Gupta. Moving on, sir, I present the candidates of the Department of Management Sciences, who, having satisfied the requirements for the degree of M.Tech, are considered worthy of receiving the same. I recommend that they be admitted to the said degree. Jai Vasan. Thank you. I further recommend that the following candidates be admitted to the degree of M.Tech in absentia: Prince Kumar, Rohit Sancha, Prathamesh Pranad Pawar, and Shankar Pal. Further, sir, I present the candidates of the Department of Management Sciences who have been satisfied the requirements of the degree of MBA are considered worthy of receiving the same. I recommend that they be admitted to this category: Ayushi Panchal, Abhishek Kumar Singh, Ashwabai Avasthi, Anant Baraskar, Ashutosh Subhash Jha, Bhakti Ajay Meke, B. Daranas, Harsh, Harshit Jain, Juturi Venkat Subramanya Sai Bharadwaj, Mayankar, Muhammad Bilal Akhtar, Nikhil Dubey, Pratik Bhav Sahab Nikam, Priyanka Reddy, Rahul Balachandran, Sri Harshdeep Agrawal. Soumya Dubey. Tapesh Vipul Gupta. Tushar Garg. V.V. Arvind is not present. Yash Yadav. I further recommend that the following candidates be admitted to the degree of MBA in absentia. Pratik Sharma, Adhish Sengotuve, Apalat Bala, Chiranjeev Mahant, Devari Harshingh Digambar Singh, Digvijay Narendra Minakshi Nikam, Harshil Negi, J. Sai Chandra, Joseph Prashant, Prithviraj Mukherjee, Rupesh Kumar R., Seri Shivateja, Harsh Pandey, and Soham Dev. Congratulations to all the delegates.
Satisfied the requirements for the postgraduate diploma in management for executives in manufacturing are considered worthy of receiving the same. I recommend that they be admitted to the said degree. Aman Gupta. Ankit Kumar Agarwal. Avinash Prasad. Anurag Garg. Deepak Kumar Singh. Gaurav Kumar. Gunjan Kumar. Kanishk Agyai Shukla. Kaushik Chandrasekhar. Yeah. Mohit Kumar Manoj Agrawal. Prathamesh Krishna Charan. Rahul Kumar. Ramesh Abutola. Absent. Sai Chandrasekhar Vedula. Sanket Yogendra Parhate. Seems to be absent. Santosh Subhash Deshmukh. Sarat Kumar Sankar. Shivam Kapoor. Shwetank Baderia. Sonu Das. Suraj Kumar Patel. Seems to be absent. Swaraj Panda. Tausif Ahmed. Absent. I further recommend that the following candidates be admitted to the postgraduate diploma in management for executives in manufacturing in absentia. Akhilesh Kumar Gupta, Ali Asghar Vilayatwala, Ankur Agarwal, Arpit Ponia, Jashir Irshad, Karthik Ramasamy, Kumar Abhinav, Naveen Tiwari, Ram Prasad E.T., Ranish Chaudhary, Rupesh Jayadas Thakre, Sarabman Singh Bakshi, Shashti Choksi, Vicky Kumar Singh, and Vivek Pradhan.
graduating students of PGTEF's VLM program. Thank you, Professor Sudhir Jaiswal and Professor Saurabh Mazumdar. You may please take your seats, which you already have. I now request Dr. Kajuli Krishnan to join the guest of honor on stage. Dr. Kajuli has been a practicing industrial physicist for 35 years. She holds a PhD in physics from IIT Kanpur, again our alumnus, and we are very proud of that. She has developed methods and algorithms for physics-based imaging system design, signal and image analysis in radar, ultrasound, near-infrared, magnetic resonance imaging, and microwave for medical and industrial applications. She has worked with a number of leading companies, and her last appointment was as principal scientist in GE. Since 2018, Kajuli has consulted on R&D projects in areas of her interest with the Indian Institute of Science and St. John's Research Institute, Bangalore, and Pune Analytics Intelligence, Chennai. She holds 5 patent grants and has authored a number of research publications. Thank you for gracing this occasion. And so for the next round of degrees, you will be given degrees by the IIT couple to the IIT to the graduating students from the IIT. Okay, I call upon DOPC Professor Prerna Gautam to call upon the E-Masters graduating students.
Very good afternoon, everyone. Sir, I present the candidates of the Department of Management Sciences who, having satisfied the requirements for the degree of E-Masters, are considered worthy of receiving the same. I recommend that they be admitted to the said degree. Aniket Chaudhary. Sharma. Gavli Ashish Lachman Rao, absent. Robin Arya. Thank you. Vikas Kumar.
Priyanka Ramnivas Keka. Rajaraman R.
Schedule. So again, compliments and congratulations to all of you.
Let me also just make one comment at the outset. I think we are very privileged that we are holding this event in a venue which is in memory of Rajiv Motwani. For those of you who don't know, Rajiv was a very eminent alum of IIT Kanpur. And there are two or three things which are quite distinctive about him. One is, of course, that he was a brilliant student, went on to do his PhD at UC Berkeley and was a faculty member at Stanford. But more interestingly, many of you might know that he was also the mentor of Page and Brin, who founded Google. And in fact, in some context, he is actually referred to as one of the people who really was an important contributor to the PageRank algorithm itself. So we are really fortunate that we are in such a venue which is in memory of such a great person. And I think an inspiration for all of us, particularly those of you who are into any kind of research degrees, shows you that you could also first be an outstanding researcher like Rajiv was, and at the same time also someone who's inspiring entrepreneurs and inspiring students to go on and do great things. So I think just keep that in mind as you go forward. Of course, I have a few formal remarks I would like to share with you this evening. First of all, I think as we all know, you are all being awarded this degree at a very exciting time. For sure, technology is changing fast. We have blockchain, IoT, augmented reality, virtual reality, and of course, AI and ML, which are sort of in a way overtaking the world. But they are also opening up many new possibilities. As a result of all these changing technologies, we also know that the jobs of tomorrow, many of them are not even known today. So you are on the verge of a very exciting career where I hope you will be able to use all that you have learned here to fashion a career that takes advantage of all these new possibilities. What's also quite clear is that developing multidisciplinary and transdisciplinary skills will be much more important in the years to come, because a lot of new skill requirements are also going to emerge. And then of course, finally, we have the geographical context of India. We know that India is hopefully, and I guess we all believe in that, that we are on the verge of a period of very significant growth, which will culminate eventually in a Viksit Bharat in 2047 or possibly even sooner. And all of you as people who are going to be very key parts of the workforce will have to contribute towards making that happen. But at the same time, everything is not so nice and well structured and so on. There are a lot of challenges we can see on the horizon. The first is that the nature of work itself is changing, leading to major changes in the workforce. There is redundancies, there are people having to retrain themselves, reskill themselves all the time. Competition is also increasing as the number of jobs is perhaps limited and the number of skilled and talented young people is of course increasing. Geopolitical tensions are clearly in the air, and many of the assumptions about the world that we made earlier are perhaps no longer true. Global warming and climate change are here for real, and I think we're all seeing it in front of us. And in spite of pronouncements from leaders across the world, we are yet to see any kind of collective action that could have any significant impact on these phenomena. Also, polarization of views and identities, and the reinforcement of this polarization by social media and technology is making meaningful collective action even more elusive than it's been so far. So there are both, I mean, as you would expect, there are both pluses and minuses as we go forward. So I guess the big question is, given this context, what should all of you be doing? So it's customary for speakers at events like this to offer advice. So I will also follow the same tradition and offer you some words of advice. But these are really more things for you to think about than specific points of advice and themselves. So what should we do? You know, as part of our MBA review a few years ago at IIM Bangalore, when we spoke to CEOs across the board, they mentioned three important phenomena that they thought we should keep in mind. One is, of course, digital, which I'm sure all of you are familiar with. The second one is data, and the third one is ESG. So I guess it goes without saying that all these three are important. I'm sure IIT Kanpur has trained you well in some way or the other for these three changing requirements. So I'm particularly sure you at least the first two, the data and the digital, you're probably well set. ESG also, I hope you are, and if not, please do make sure that you are. But what's also interesting is that just before the pandemic, and that's not very long ago, right? It's just about 4 years ago. I recall in my strategy course, we discussed a lot of interesting case studies. We discussed a case study on the airline industry. We looked at Airbnb. We looked at a lot of these other digital businesses. But amazingly, the class never considered even for a moment that any of these industries would come to a grinding halt just a few months later. That thought never crossed our mind in the class discussion. But as we all know, that's exactly what happened, right? Air travel globally almost came to a halt. The travel and tourism and hotel industries just, again, suffered very significantly. So clearly, there are some lessons we need to take away from that. And those are particularly relevant in the context which I just set out for all of you. The first, thing I would request you to keep in mind is that you should avoid and overcome decision-making biases. I'm sure somewhere along the line you would have studied. There are several biases we fall into almost all the time. For example, confirmation bias. We have a particular hypothesis and then we just take in whatever data supports that. We reject all data that seems to come into conflict with that hypothesis. You all know about things like recency and a whole lot of other decision-making biases that come into play. We could see a lot of that visible in the initial reaction to COVID. Many companies just struggled because they were so accustomed to doing things in a particular way. So I would urge you to keep these decision-making biases in mind and do whatever you can to avoid and overcome them. Secondly, it's also quite clear, evident at this point of time, that practicing scenario planning is very important. Again, I hope you've all had some exposure to scenario planning. Scenario planning essentially tells you that you cannot predict the future. None of us can. But what you can do is improve your preparedness for the future. How do you do that? By visualizing entirely different scenarios that might come about and getting through the thought process of how you would deal with those scenarios if they were to actually happen. Again, the focus is not on whether any of those specific scenarios will happen, but it's the thought process that really matters. Some of you might know that many, many years ago when the first oil shock hit in the early 70s, and again maybe a decade later when the second oil shock hit, the oil company globally that was best prepared to deal with all of these was Shell. And Shell attributed its success mainly to the fact that it had been an adept exponent of scenario planning. Essentially, they had not predicted any of these shocks, but since they had gone to a lot of thought exercises on how they would deal with different scenarios, they were simply much better prepared to handle it. And by the way, remember, just having the scenario in mind is not good enough. You need to go through this process. And just on a lighter note, if you go back to IndiGo's IPO prospectus, you will see that one of the risk factors they mentioned in the prospectus was SARS-like epidemics affecting travel. But I don't know to what extent they really thought about this seriously, because had they really, you know, taken that to heart, they would be much better prepared. What it also means is that we should look for and read weak signals. I don't know if you remember at the time when COVID hit India, you know, March, April 2020, the first signs of COVID becoming an important global phenomenon were already visible. In fact, if you go just 2-3 months behind before that, there were already cases being reported in other parts of the world, and companies who paid attention to those weak signals were simply much better prepared. So please do look out for those weak signals. And of course, please do factor in risks, build better contingency plans, whether that be in your personal life or in the life of the organization you work for. Speaking of technology, obviously you all need to keep abreast of GenAI and AI tools. They've all become a part of almost everyday life today. But I would just request you to remember one thing. The distinctiveness of human beings comes from creativity, from empathy, and from human values. So while Gen AI for their alumni reunions, 10, 15, or 20 years later, and I've been meeting them in this context now for a long time, they all have one common theme. The common theme that they share with us is that they wish they had paid more attention to the OB and HR courses in their MBA program. Because when they finally went into their jobs, while all the other skills mattered, perhaps people skills were what really made the difference between being a successful performer and otherwise. So please develop your people skills. Maybe I should be giving this advice to the students who are joining your program as well, not only the graduating ones. But even if you missed out or didn't pay so much attention to OB and HR while you were here as students, and I guess this is particularly relevant to our MBA friends, please do focus on them because they'll be going to be very important in the years going forward. In fact, I hear from many youngsters that their idea is working from home, doing cool things, you know, making sort of individual heroic contributions. But that's not how organizations work. Finally, organizations work by people working together in teams. That's what really makes impact. So if you want to be an effective manager, you have to work with people. And don't forget Mary Angelou's very important advice: people remember how you make them feel. So that's finally what you're going to leave with all the people you interact with. Let me move on to another point, which is on stamina and resilience. In this tough world, and I'm sure our EMBA students who all look, you know, much more older, mature, wiser, if I may say so, I'm sure you've already realized this, you will realize very soon that stamina and resilience are critical. And you can't have stamina and resilience unless you maintain good physical and mental health. So find ways of keeping physically fit, otherwise health problems can hit you just as your career is beginning to soar. And I'm particularly concerned about mental health, particularly after the pandemic, because it seems to be a challenge that we are not handling too well. Maintain friendships and social relationships. And here I mean in person, not on Instagram or WhatsApp. Keep connected to your family, and I'm happy to see so many of your family members here today and others you care for. Be part of professional and social organizations. The metaverse may be exciting, but humans are basically wired to be social beings. So please do keep that in mind. I would also urge all of you to focus on being what are called impact players. So in a competitive workforce, if you really want to differentiate or distinguish yourself, it helps if you can aspire to be an impact player. What's the difference between being an impact player and being just a mere contributor? You might like to read a very interesting bestseller written by Liz Wiseman in 2021 with the same title. It's called Impact Players. A high impact player does work of exceptional value and impact, whereas contributors are smart and talented people who are doing solid, if not, but not necessarily great work. So what's the difference? How would you become an impact player rather than just a mere contributor? So faced with uncertainty and ambiguity, Liz Wiseman identifies five factors that distinguish an impact player from a contributor. The impact player does the job that is needed rather than what is just the defined job, steps up to lead rather than waiting for direction, moves things across the finish line rather than escalating problems, learns and adapts to change rather than attempting to manage and minimize change. Some of you might have heard about Carol Dweck's growth mindset, you might like to look at that. And typically an impact player makes heavy demands lighter by working well with others rather than adding to the load. So I know this is probably a lot in a short time, but I would urge you to have a quick look at Liz Wiseman's book, because she offers some really useful advice on how you can be more of an impact player. And by the way, in the context that I described to you right in the beginning, where there's much more uncertainty, much more ambiguity, a lot of factors outside our control, there's going to be an even more significant requirement for impact players in the years ahead. I'm coming towards the end of my talk, just a couple more points I would like to mention. So while you will be all focused on building your skill sets and profile, I would also urge you to keep your mind open for taking on some of the larger challenges that are visible before us. In this context, I would like to underline the need and importance of social sensitivity. Please keep connected to the broader environment, to the place or region to which your family belongs, to the institutions where you have studied. I'm quite proud that, you know, I graduated from IIT Kanpur a long time ago, 38 years ago, but I'm still in touch. I've been here several times over the years. What they missed out in my bio, by the way, is an important thing. I've also been president of IIT Kanpur Alumni Association at a pretty young age, so I've actually been involved with the institute in more ways than you can imagine. So I would urge you all to keep connected to your family and institutions where you have studied. As graduates from a leading institution like IITK, you automatically belong to a privileged group. That goes without saying. So you don't have to wait to give back to society and to the community. You should make it a part of your life right now. What I've seen with a lot of people is those who get involved in community activities when they're young, they continue to have that connection throughout their life. So I would urge you to do that. Identify causes or organizations you relate to. Keep aside some time for them. And you will find that this not only helps others, but also adds meaning to your own existence. And in a way, helps you combat any of the mental health challenges which we certainly don't want you to have to face in your life going forward. Professor Rebecca Henderson of Harvard was the foundation case speaker at our Golden Jubilee Foundation Day at IIM Bangalore last year. And she gave a wonderful talk on reimagining capitalism in a world on fire, which is also, by the way, the title of a book she wrote. Professor Henderson urged all of us to embrace a purpose beyond profit and to dare to act. And I would like to give you a short quotation from her book because it's also related to one of the challenges I mentioned at the outset of my talk. Climate change is not about warmer weather. It is about instability. Stable climate is a prerequisite for our very existence. Otherwise, it would lead to catastrophic conditions. We need a political, social, and cultural global movement to address huge issues like climate change. Business can be a powerful ally and make a great deal of money in the process. And making money, maximizing profits, should be a means to an end, not an end in itself. The goal of market is to create a thriving society. Adopting authentic purpose can significantly increase performance. But I think she's just bringing it all together. Bringing together the importance of purpose, of course, the importance of the environment and the earth itself. So Professor Henderson's call to adopt an authentic purpose is as relevant to us as individuals as it is to businesses and corporations, which are at the end of the day led by people like you and me. In fact, purpose is important in whatever you do, even if you are finally going to be working with AI. Some of you may have seen this comment on a cartoon which was going the rounds in WhatsApp groups, I'm sure most of you would have seen it, where the person in the cartoon is actually saying, you know what's the biggest problem with pushing all things AI? It's going in the wrong direction. I want AI to do my laundry and dishes so that I can do art and writing, not for AI to do my art and writing so that I can do my laundry and clothes. So just keep that in mind. I think that's an important thing. I mean, whatever we are pushing, new technology, whatever, it certainly should focus on taking away the drudgery of life, but not the things that really give us meaning and purpose. So once again, let me congratulate all of you for having completed your degrees and your education here at IIT Kanpur. Let me exhort all of you to please engage with your family, with society, with some causes you really care for. I've given you a lot of other advice and points to think about. But in all, I wish you all very well, and I look forward to reading very exciting things about all of you in the future. Take care. Jai.
Have no doubt that as you excel personally and professionally,
or even if you are at your lows, which is perfectly fine, you can always come back to the department for a cup of tea. Right. With this, I will invite Seema to probably share her times at IIT Kanpur here.
Speak back. So, dear Professor Krishna, Dr. Banerjee, Dr. Jaiswal, esteemed faculty members, dear staff members, my dear young PhD friends and students at DLS and their parents. As I hold the PhD degree, thank you comes as a very small gesticulation towards expression of my gratitude towards this department, IME or DLS. I started with IME. Earning something as big as this can never be an individual effort, and that holds true in my case too. Many of you all here know that I have been associated with this department for the past 16 years. So I owe gratitude not just for the 4.5 years of my PhD stint here, but for a lot more. Don't know how I begin to thank each one in the department. Seems impossible, but let me try. First of all, from the bottom of my heart, I thank all faculty members who mentor and advise me throughout coursework, through PhD milestones and further research work, and even before that when I was a project employee. I'm overwhelmed that they still continue to do that. A drop of a mail is enough. While this learning journey, I can't thank enough my supervisor, Professor Fani, enough for providing me space, supporting my abilities, and guiding me all through these 16 years of my tenure in the department. Apart from being instrumental in my personal development, I'm happy to share that due to his constant inputs, motivation, and encouragement, I earned 2 A-category journal papers and 1 UNESCO journal paper as a first author. Other than 2 other journals, the major push to take up the joint degree program from Curtin University of Australia also came from him. He said, if you don't go there, I will not supervise you. Professor Shubhankar Mukherjee, thank you so much for being there always on Zoom calls, WhatsApp messages, in-person meetings, and of course, mails. I'm unable to put in words as to how valuable your input has been while unknowingly mentored or guided me even during our informal meetups. Interacting with you as a friend, more than as a supervisor student combo, has been phenomenal. With different perspectives, it was an amazing, enriching experience with my Curtin supervisors, Professor Subhra Anantram and Professor Subha Barida, along with a different country experience while my 1 year stay at Perth in Australia for the joint degree program. I generously thank the staff of DOMS for being so supportive and helpful all the time when I needed assistance, even at the last minute. Thank you, Rajendraji, Praveenji, Vandana, Shalini, Radhe, Saksham, and all those who are missing out on, my apologies for that, headed by Dr. Supriya Katti, who was always there for all-round help, and especially for a kappa when I needed it the most. I can't finish this thank you note without thanking my PhD buddies, who, despite the age difference, bestowed upon me so much love and respect. I learned a lot from them during this time, and I carry such beautiful memories of my time spent with them, enjoying birthdays, tea outings, chit chats, and much more. I will cherish this throughout lifetime. Last but not the least, I completely owe this degree to my beloved family members, who stood like rocks every time I lost hope or found myself wavering. As I leave the department physically, I request each one of you to continue to guide me even in future. With that, I wish you all a very happy life ahead. Once again, thank you for helping me out.
Honorable Chief Guests, respected faculty members, dear family, friends, and fellow graduates. First of all, I am deeply honored and grateful to receive the Mrs. and Mr. S. N. Mittal Gold Medal and the Professor Vijay Mahajan Award. These recognitions are a testament not only to my efforts, but also to the unwavering support and guidance I have received throughout this journey. When I was asked to give this farewell speech, I knew it would be a challenge to summarize my MBA experience of 2 years in just 5 minutes. But here I am giving it my best shot. For many of us, pursuing MBA was not just a personal dream, but also a dream shared by our family members. Today, as we stand here, having realized that dream, we are inspired to achieve even bigger things. Today is a celebration of the culmination of years of hard work. To reach this point, we have studied diligently as undergraduates, worked late hours in our pre-MBA careers, and dedicated countless hours to preparing for the CAT exam. My batchmate, as this journey draws to a close, let's revisit some of our shared memories. From late night study sessions that often ended with gossips and tea at hall level canteen, to the last minute rush of submitting Professor Funny's assignment. From racing our cycles to IIM building and to printing the same material and calling it a cheat sheet for our open book exams. We have come a long way both individually and as a batch. As we reflect on these moments, we must also acknowledge our professors who have been pivotal during our MBA journey, not just as educators, but as mentors who guided us at every stage. I want to extend my heartfelt thanks to a few who profoundly impacted my perspective during my times at DOMS IIT Kanpur. Professor Amit Shukla sir, your structured teaching methodology and case-based projects encouraged me to delve deeper into subjects. Professor Jitendra Kumar, your insights into marketing and the emphasis on product experience broadened my understanding of the field. Professor Vinay Ramani sir, your classes on competitive strategies were among the best that I have attended. Professor Suvendu Naskar, as the faculty coordinator of the placement committee, your tireless efforts have been instrumental, and under your leadership, the future looks even brighter. I have learned a lot and working under your guidance. And finally, Professor Funny, your constant support and open door policy for every student have been a moral booster, encouraging the students to work for the betterment of the department and the MBA program. Our time here wouldn't have been as enriching and enjoyable without the support of our batchmates, who have become like a second family to us. My dear friend Harshit Jain, Ashutosh Jha, Nikhil and Soumya, you have made this journey unforgettable for me. The knowledge and experience we shared during projects, our lunches at the Doha canteen, coffee chats at CCD, the countless nights out are priceless and unforgettable memories for me. The awards I have received today are as much yours as they are mine, because without your support, it wouldn't have been possible. I would also want to acknowledge few of my batchmates, Bhakti Mete, Bhadwa Jutri, Anand Baraskar, Rajdeep Agarwal, Tushar and Rahul, for your contribution during classroom discussions. Because your inputs not only made me smarter, but have also enriched the entire batch learning experience. And at last, none of these would have been possible without the love and sacrifices of our family members. Today is a day to thank all who have shaped us. On behalf of my batchmates, I extend a heartfelt gratitude to our parents. Our parents have made immense sacrifices to invest in our education, and we are forever indebted to them. To all the mothers sitting here, thank you for your unwavering support. To all the fathers who are present here, thank you for nurturing our dreams and being our silent supporters. To all the siblings and partners who reminded us to take it easy during rejection or on a very hectic day, thank you for your support. On a personal note, I would also like to express my deepest gratitude to my late grandfather. Without him, I wouldn't be half the person I am today. When my friends ask where do I get the motivation to put in that extra effort, I replied that it was because of a promise I made to him, to never take half measures and to approach every task with total commitment. Each day, I strive to fulfill that promise, knowing he is watching from heaven above and smiling down on me. In conclusion, my friends, as we part ways, do remember everything that this great institution has done for us, and now it's our time to pay back. And probably Fani sir will agree with this part. Thank you everyone, and congratulations to the ITK DOMS batch of 2024. Thank you.
His wife, who also is a parent of now I invite Professor Saurabh to present the vote of thanks. After the vote of thanks, these are these high teams, so please wait for that. This is just outside this hall. So Saurabh, over to you.
Respected Chief Guest Professor Rishikesh Krishnan, Director of IIM Bangalore, esteemed guests, faculty members, graduating students, parents, and family members. On behalf of the Department of Management Sciences at IIT Kanpur, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to all those who have made this convocation ceremony a memorable success. Firstly, we are deeply honored by the presence of our esteemed Chief Guest Professor Rishikesh Krishnan, Director of IIM Bangalore, and alumnus. His career serves as a beacon of aspiration for our graduating students to the heights our alumni. Your insightful speech today has been inspirational for our graduating students, encouraging them to aim high and embrace coming challenges. We are also privileged to have with us Dr. Kakoli Banerjee Krishnan, an illustrious alumna and a practicing industrial physicist of over 35 years. Our heartfelt thanks to Professor Sudhir Shivkumar Jaiswal, Chairperson of PGPX VLM program at IIM Calcutta, for gracing us with his presence. We extend our sincere thanks to Professor Kripa Shankar, former faculty of Department of Management Sciences and former Vice Chancellor of Delhi Technical University, Lucknow, and Professor Jayanta Chatterjee, former faculty of Department of Management Sciences, for gracing us with their presence today and for their valuable contributions to our department's legacy. A special thanks goes to the parents and family members of our graduating students for their support in the success of our students. To our graduating students, today marks a significant milestone in your journey. Your dedication, perseverance, and accomplishments are a testament to your hard work and determination. I extend sincere appreciation to the faculty members and the head of Department of Management Sciences for their tireless efforts in guiding and shaping the future leaders of tomorrow. I extend earnest thanks to our current students, staff, and members of the media for their presence and support throughout this event. Lastly, a special thanks to the Department of Computer Science and Engineering for generously providing us with the venue and their technical staff for this ceremony. I extend our warm appreciation to the dedicated student volunteers whose invaluable assistance has been instrumental in organizing today's ceremony. Thank you once again, and congratulations to the graduating class of 2024. I wish you all the best in your journey. We are immensely proud of each and every one of you. Thank you.
Outside, and please make way for the guests first, and have a nice evening.